sadly, this is the drive home from just an absolutely amazing, amazing weekend. I couldn't, my wildest dreams, I could have never have expected what happened. Like, I was, the plan, like, in my head, I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna go, I'm gonna try to, you know, I'm gonna see what I can do in Nations vs. Zombies, I'm gonna try to make it to day two, you know, maybe meet some cool people, you know, hopefully I'll play at Thunderdome. My dumb self forgot to take into account how awesome and accepting the Nerf community is. I ended up staying in the same hotel as Guerrilla Tactical, a bunch of other Nerfers. We were all in the same hotel. They're like Evan B. and Fowler, and my, the guy who I was wingman for like the entire time that we were alive, Russ, who is totally badass. I already miss like hanging out with these people because they were all really, really awesome. Next thing you know, I'm on squad with Evan B. and Fowler, and I'm wingman to Russ, and we're running through all these missions and everything. Like, it was a lot of fun. It was amazing. Some of the missions, the escort missions, got a little daunting, but that's not my choice. That's the moderator's choice. And then going to Thunderdome and playing at Thunderdome and being accepted at Thunderdome. Accepted to the point where one of the guys who's there quite often, Watson, if you're watching, hi Watson, I miss you. Watson doing Watson things, and he gave me my own Thunderdome name. I am now the Thunderdome Troll. I am Troll. Like, people were hollering out Troll. He was hollering out Troll, and I was coming down. I was back in the arena, and I was, you know, we were playing. Meeting Jack from Thunderdome, Nova Scotia, and everybody was just so chill. Everybody was just so cool. I got to use Jack's crossbow up in the tower. That was an experience, and one that I will get hate from Clowny. I know that I will. I already told him, like, I was running game. I was running games in Thunderdome. Beautiful, beautiful time. Amazing people. I almost don't want to go home. No, I really don't want to go home. I want to stay there and live, you know, in the Nerfy life. Such a great time. Everybody was just so cool. Oh, the guy that went off in the ambulance, I found out what that was. It wasn't heat stroke. What it was, I mean, yes, he was kind of tired. But what it really was, he was fighting off a group of zombies. He went down and smashed his head. So they carried him back to human HQ, and then the ambulance showed up. He got back. Got cleared from the hospital, got back before the end of the final mission. He was mad that he was missing final mission. He loaded up and did a one-man breach into that zombie-filled parking garage and fought his way to the top. He made it all the way back up to the top to fight everyone off, and got slaughtered in the process during the final charges, but nonetheless, that's dedication. That's Nerf family, is what that is. Like, check out this tan line. Check that out. Right across there, because I had my hat on almost the entire time. Also, something that I haven't seen in Pennsylvania in a long time, Sobe, Citrus Energy. I have not seen this in Pennsylvania for months, maybe a year or two. but I have a really long drive home. The horrible lying GPS tells me it's a 14-hour run. 14 hours and 38 minutes from now. I don't think that's right. It took me nearly 20 hours to get here. I don't know if that was construction problems or what. But on the way here, it told me, yeah, 15. 15 and change, actually. And then on the way back, it's 14 hours and 37 minutes. All right, yeah, okay, we'll see about that. Because I also have to cross a time zone, so that'll put me an hour behind. One thing that I am happy about, I actually have a decent night's sleep this time. Full 7-8 hours, something along those lines. It's still daylight. So the scary parts going through St. Louis, which I really didn't like when I was headed out here, because wow, people in St. Louis are... I apologize if you live in St. Louis, but some of the people that I saw driving in St. Louis drive like absolute animals. Like, I mean, I've seen aggressive drivers coming from, you know, Harrisburg and Philly and Jersey and everything, but wow. I'm very excited for the next Nations vs. Zombies. It's going to be in Athens, Ohio, which is a lot closer. Turns this whole trip into an 8-hour run. And that one, I'm saying this now, Clowney, Van, DX, Aeromech, pretty much anybody else from the Northeast, Gears, better be there. Clowney's going to be there if I have to drag his fat ass by myself. I don't know how you found this channel, but if you haven't already, found Clowney Nerf, go check him out. Check out Evan B. Check out Thunderdome. Check out Fala from Blono Nerf. J Nerf. Drac. Bobo. Vlad. Alice Pipe Duck. Code Duck Pipe Duck. I don't remember. I am sorry. There'll be links to channels of all the really cool people in the description box below. I'm just so excited. Like, it's almost heartbreaking to drive home because I know I have to wait a year to see some of those people again. And that's sad. But it's okay. It's okay. Because I know I have something to look forward to. A lot of times in life, we don't look down the track far enough. And you get that mentality of, well, I have nothing to live for. I don't have, you know, anything going on. I don't have anything to look forward to. That means you gotta search. That means you gotta search for something. Like, set a goal of somewhere you want to go, something you want to do. And it doesn't have to be huge. It can be really, like, stupid and small. It doesn't matter. As long as it's something that you want to work towards, that's all you need. Like, going to Nations vs. Zombies really kept me trucking. I mean, I had some really bad days. I nearly quit my job. Things got kind of dark, real dark, and I couldn't, one thing that just kept me on track and pushing and moving and doing was coming to Nations vs. Zombies. It kept me active, it kept me going. I mean, I'm not as active as I should have been, because I had planned on doing conditioning running, but my fat butt just did not do it. just did not do it. But I survived. I didn't tank out from heat stroke or exhaustion. I did have to walk away, but that was, well, you know. Set goals, man. I was never a believer in setting goals for yourself. I was like, that's a cool idea and all, but meh. Until this whole Nations vs. Zombies thing, like, I set the goal of, I'm going. And I started to fund. And I got the money to, I actually met the people, the one guy from the Denver Howling Commandos who did donate to my GoFundMe to help get me here. And if you're watching, thank you again. I love you. That was something else fun. Yelling I love you at everybody in Thunderdome as I'm firing at them. I will kill you with love. I came up out of the Wobbly Sausage, which was the boat, the USS Wobbly Sausage. And I was just like, I love you! I love you! I love you! I love you! Firing away with the hammer shot. So much fun. So enjoyable. So sad to go home. I just saw a billboard. And I had to read it 3 times to make sure I was reading it right. Apparently, locally, somewhere not too far away from here, there's a town, Uranus, however you want to pronounce it. So Uranus, it's the planet, Uranus, whatever. The billboard said, we're having big fun in Uranus. And there was a dinosaur on it, so I don't know what's happening in that town. Don't think I'm gonna stop. Just saying. Oh, what the hell? Okay, so now you've taken it too far, Missouri. Apparently, I just went through Uranus. Whose genius idea was it to make the Uranus Fudge Factory? I need to know. I'm not lying. The sign back there said Uranus Fudge Factory and Cream Store. I just... phrasing. Oh my god. Oh, why you do this? Why you do this, Missouri? Wouldn't trade this road trip for anything, even though I'm going to be completely exhausted by the end of it. It's stuff like that that makes it worth it. If I'd have flown, I would have missed out on Uranus. Oh, man. This is, I mean, one thing I will say about Missouri, now that I can actually see it, because when I came through here before, it was pitch black and I was exhausted. Missouri is actually quite lovely. Like, driving along the highway, and it's just wall-to-wall green on either side. Just trees and trees and trees and trees. And that's just, it's beautiful. This probably looks amazing in autumn. It's all the different colors and everything from the trees turning. This probably looks fantastic in autumn. Because right now, it's just so green and lush looking. Oh, my goodness. Very warm in Missouri. I think we were pushing into the 90s, like pushing close to 100. So, I mean, it's been rough, but survived. Sunburned, yes, but not crazy sunburned. Like, I'm not at that I can't move sunburn. Jump cuts. Jump cuts as far as the eye can see, because I don't know what I'm doing when it comes to editing. Ran into another guy from Nation vs. Zombies while I was out here on the road. The guy that actually was carried off in the ambulance. I'm just driving along and I've got Nations vs. Zombies like written in that like window chalk stuff on both my windows. And they're like, hey, there's a guy. And I look over and like, cause they're running like right next to me. I'm like, what's it? And it's him. And he's like waving. And I'm like, yo, what's up? Hey, how's it going? And he pulls up in front of me and he starts slowing down. And I'm like, does he want me to pass him? So I get out and I pass him. He's got his GoPro out. And I give him the thumbs up as I roll past him so you can see the Nations vs. Zombies thing. This is what I mean, man. Like, Nerfers are family. Like, it doesn't matter where you're from. Anywhere. Doesn't matter where. Everybody has this weird same mentality. And it's beautiful. It's something that's up on Thunderdome. There's a sign up in Thunderdome, like right on the balcony. Not balcony. There's a roof over like the porched in area. And it says, time well wasted. Somebody had said about that, time well wasted. I don't really get that. And I'm like, well, that's simple enough. Like, a lot of people would see that playing with Nerf toys and Nerf blasters and everything like that, and doing what we're doing, is just a waste of time. Like, you're just wasting your life. You're wasting time playing with these stupid toys. But it's time well wasted because you meet family. People that I've met once at a war, or talk to online just through like the various groups and Facebook and, you know, forums and everything, I've formed stronger bonds with them than people that I went to school with for years. Yeah, people that I went to high school with and everything like that, like I see them every so often and nothing. It's horrible to say, but I don't really care. It's difficult to figure out what to say, because saying that they don't matter is a bit crass. Because all life matters. When it really boils down to it, everybody matters. But in the sphere of how you live your life and who influences you and everything like that, like, unless you have a common ground, a lot of times they're going to try to tear you away from what they think is weird or not right. But that's the trick. There are other people out there, just like you, that are into the exact same things that you are. And it is weird to be like, well, I really like Nerf stuff. I love playing with Nerf. It's weird. Like, I got some really funny, are you serious kind of looks when I was telling people that I was taking my vacation time, using my vacation to go to Missouri for a weekend of, you know, like playing with Nerf toys and Nerf blasters and, you know, humans versus zombies. And, like, they're like, are you serious? That's what you're not going to the beach? You're not like getting hammered? You're not? No, I'm going to sweat my ass off on a college campus and shoot some zombies. I got some weird looks from that. I got some flack for that too. But it doesn't matter because they don't get it. I get it. The people around me, they get it. So, that's what matters. That's all that matters. Is that the people that you run with, they're the ones that get it. It's about cutting out the negative influences in life. You know, excuse me. Some people will never, ever be happy with how their life is, how other people's lives are. And if they can't control your life, then they're mad. And that's just how some people operate. And there's really nothing you can do about it, except to start to like cut those people away. And after a while, you will see that your life starts to get a little bit easier, because that negative influence is gone. And you can focus more on the positive effects, the positive things that are going in life. And even turning the negative energy that other people force on you, like you're having a bad day. This is something that I do quite often. If I'm having a bad day and I'm trying to wrap my head around getting through the day, and I just so boiled down and half broken, and I don't know what to do anymore. A lot of times I will force myself to work on a project. I'll be like, all right, no, I gotta go work on a project. And I'll tear one of my blasters apart, and I'll just stare at it and be like, oh, how can I make this better? You know, or start doing and tinkering and working and trying this and trying that. And after a while, the negative side of things just kind of drifts away, and you no longer remember why you were mad in the first place, and it begins to make a turn, especially if the mod is going right. Especially if, like, what you're working on is starting to turn out the way you want it to, you can turn a really crap mood into super happy in 30 minutes, depending on what you're doing. I've had it happen to me. Child in a bad mood, come home, work on something. Yes, it's working, da 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 da. And I was in a good mood again. It's all about finding the positive in life. It'll really help you out. The hard part is over. We made it back to Flat State. I mean Illinois. So flat out here. It's... But the hard part's over. Looking at the drive between 44, 55, and then 70, which is what I'm on now, that was not fun when I was as tired as I was. But this time I actually got a nice view of St. Louis. Now we start the long haul. Route 70 for 3-4 states. Until I hit back to the Pennsylvania Turnpike. I miss Missouri already. I wish that I could be back there and, you know, playing, instead of driving for like a day. But if I, like I said before, if I have any issues or problems, I stop and grab a Cliff Bar. I have energy drinks. I have 5-hour energy, so there's... Next year, in Athens, it's gonna be a far less hard hike to get to, and you better believe that I'm gonna be there. So if you're seeing this and you're all and you're weathering
whether or not,
if you're seeing this and you're wondering whether or not making the trek to Nations versus Zombies is worth it, it's worth it. Especially if there's another DarkCon, if you have any interest in Nerf and Nation and Humans vs. Zombies, it is an amazing game. Yeah, problems with game types, doesn't matter. Just about everybody had an absolute blast. You know, you get to see some of these people that you've only seen on YouTube in action. And I gotta tell you, I do have to say that there are some fierce players in the game. watching these guys just take off and knock zombies out. Remember that dude that I told you about? That, you know, I saw him on the highway and he had the GoPro. Well, he did it again. Just ran into him again. Only this time his buddy from the passenger seat was firing a Busby Sentinel at my car. Hilarious. If I had the window down, he would have hit me in the face. Oh, but no, I'm driving up and I'm just like, nah, that's not him again. That's not him again. I see a zombie strike guard on the antenna. I'm like, that's definitely a nerfer. That's definitely someone who nerfs, because only, you know, idiots put nerf darts on their antennas. And yeah, any ways for me to go around? They're firing a sentinel at me. I'm like, this is genius. This is absolute genius. Oh, this trip has been so much fun. Like, I can't express to you the amount of joy and happiness, acceptance and love that I've gotten out of this trip. To walk into Thunderdome on the last day, a place that I only dreamed of going to. Yeah, I only dreamed of going to Thunderdome because it was so far away, I thought I was never going to make it there. So get to Thunderdome, play for like 3 days at Thunderdome, and they're like, Watson looks at me and goes, Troll, get your hand in some paint, do something, sign it. Are you serious? Yeah. So there's a picture. Life's more fun when it's weird. Hang on. Does that mean that I was just involved in a drive-by shooting? Drive-by sentineling? Drive-by nerfing? You be the judge. I know it's a relatively unfair assessment to just judge what I'm seeing for Illinois, but so far I am not a fan. Like, I know that there are things, cool things in Illinois. Like, I know there's plenty of cool stuff and nice places and good people, but along Route 70, it's just farm. That's all you see, and it's so boring. I'm not expecting to get home until about 4 a.m. The last I checked the GPS, it said, oh, you'll be home at 1:57. You and I both know that that is not happening. This is not a 15-hour drive. This is not a 14.34-hour drive. 14-hour and 37-minute drive, like it told me this morning. No, not even. Oh, see, yeah. That's Illinois, the home of the world's largest rocking chair and world's largest golf team. Woo. Exciting. There's just no escaping. There's no escaping. Apparently on the road home, there's plenty of people who have been at NVZ as well. So I'm, where the hell am I? Marshall, Illinois? Bleh. I don't like this place. I stopped here on the way up, but that's not important. I stopped at McDonald's and come out to my car, and there's a Busby sticky dart on my window. So I stop and I look around and I don't see anybody. And I did what any responsible adult would do. Put it on my car antenna. Cause that's what you're supposed to do. I don't know, it's this weird, like, it makes you feel like you're not alone out here on this road. that just will never end. Forgot how long it takes to get out of Illinois. But anyway, thank you for the dart, whoever the hell you are. It will proudly be on my car antenna until it is no longer there. Back to the road. Got me some nuggets, baby. Some chicken nuggets. Back up to speed and away we go. There it is. Oh, there's the sign. Welcome to Indiana. I'm out of Illinois. Holy crap. I think Illinois is the worst part of this trip. I just feel better now that I'm not in Illinois anymore. I'm in Indiana. Home of Naptown Nerf, by the way. If you don't know who that is, check the link. You can find them. They're awesome. Zach and Jill. Total beasts on the field. I'm telling you. But anyway. I didn't realize that I was that close to the border of Indiana. So, crossed the border, and I see a sign that says one, and I turned into the pigeon, the seagulls from Finding Nemo. One, 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 one. I did. I was. And then I saw the show me that sweet, sweet sign. Oh, there it is. I feel better now that I know that I'm not in Illinois anymore. Because Illinois sucks. And I will stand by that until the day that I am proven wrong. That's what I say. Done. Indiana, I love you, but you gotta work on these roads, my friend. Oh my goodness, like I could swear I'm back in PA with how many potholes I just ran over coming from the airport to through like Indianapolis itself. Oh, fix your roads. On the bright side, the construction seems to be less this time through. I mean, when I came the other direction, I mean, I hit here around rush hour. It's right around 5 o'clock, and I mean, this entire road that I'm on right now was just jammed up all the way to the airport. Like, it was stop and go traffic the entire way. So, that's a good thing that I missed rush hour in Indianapolis. Yeah, as I repeat myself,
I can talk.
I'm actually quite proud of myself here. I ran through all of Indianapolis at a straight shot. Straight through, no stopping, all of Indianapolis. I am in Ohio. That means I am a state and a quarter away, because I don't count the 12 miles of West Virginia as an actual state. It's a very top corner of West Virginia. That means I'm not too far off from home. I won't make it before the sun goes down. It's now 8 o'clock. It's not a joke, is it? They always say it's the trip out there that's the problem. It's the trip back. That just, like, the trip to someplace takes forever. The trip from someplace doesn't seem to take as long. That's really what's happening here. I mean, it's 8 o'clock. I left my hotel by, I want to say it was 11 o'clock Eastern time. So that means that, I mean, I'll be home. I'm still thinking that I'm not going to even be anywhere near home till I don't know, what, 3-4 o'clock in the morning, something like that. That's really what I'm thinking at this point. But hey, if that's what it is, then that's beautiful. That means that I can get some sleep, get up, and then I have an entire day to unwind, see friends, and tell my really fun stories and the insanity that I just had. But first and foremost, I'm hitting this rest area because, like, I have been sitting since, like, the end of Illinois. I need to get up and stretch. Oh my goodness. All of Indiana in a single shot. I am proud of myself. Doing good on the tired meter. Them chicken nuggets hit the spot. I'm not a total chicken nugget freak. It's just... That really worked for me. No, that's handicapped. I'm not handicapped. All right. Time to stretch. Oh my goodness. Class. Not sure how much more filming I'm gonna be able to get in. Really starting to lose the light. Don't know if I'm gonna be able to get anything in my lovely home state of Pennsylvania. We'll check back in once I do get home though. Obviously if I'm posting this, I got home. But regardless, it's for the video, man. But the trip home is definitely not as daunting. I don't know if it's just that I'm more prepared for this trip home, that I got more sleep. Because on the way out, I only had like 4 hours sleep. Yeah, think about that for a second. 4 hours sleep in a 20-hour drive. It wasn't pretty. I actually did have to pull over at some point and take a nap on the way out. But on the way back, I'm good. I don't really want to be going home. I wish that something like that could just last forever. I really do. Like, that was time well wasted. I made it back to PA. I have 3 tunnels. This is the first of 3. Two tunnels. Can you tell I'm sleep deprived? So close. So close. It's like 4 o'clock in the morning now. Yep. 4 o'clock in the morning. Next time I get the bright idea to drive 1,000 miles in a day by myself, somebody hit me. Oy. I did this to myself, so I can't really blame anybody. One more tunnel and I'm home. Let's hope it goes fast. You know what this lighting means? It means it's the last tunnel. I am within striking distance of home. Another probably 40, 50 miles, something like that. I'm burning as hard as I can, but there's a lot of fog back there. And that slowed me down. Can't see in the fog, so you gotta slow down. But so close I can taste it now. Hi, it's Beaker from the future. I'm sitting here editing the video and I realized I never actually did a wrap up for this. Mainly because I was completely and totally annihilated tired by the time I got home. But I said it like 100 times during the video. It was an amazing experience. I would not trade it for anything, and I can't wait for next year. So if you made it this far into the video, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in Athens. I completely blanked out on what else I was going to say, so I'll just, later days. Oh, I suck at this.